So the very famous Sir Paul McCartney was recently featured on a podcast where he explained how doing eye exercises or eye yoga has saved him from needing glasses. It turns out this is not news. He's been making these claims and preaching about eye exercises for some time now. There's even an old YouTube video that he made going through his whole process. Now, this is probably the oldest and longest running myth about eyes that's out there, and it really stems from a poor understanding of physics and how the eyes work. So let's break down what's really happening. Hey, what's up? This is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. If you're new here and like learning about the eyes, then consider hitting the subscribe button down below and ring the bell so that you don't miss any of our future videos. Now, the eyes and the visual system is incredibly complex, and even for most healthcare workers out there, if they are not a specialist in the area of the eyes, they probably don't fully understand how it works. Now, the eye exercises that Sir Paul McCartney has been teaching is basically looking up, down, left, right, and looking at different diagonal directions and doing a couple sets of those, along with focusing on the tip of his nose and, again, repeating that several times. Now, your eyeballs have six pairs of external eye muscles that we call extraocular muscles, and they do help your eyes look up, look down, left, right, but they also have torsional muscles that allow your eyes to twist and turn whenever you're turning your head and tilting it from side to side. That way, your eyes stay in alignment and you don't end up seeing double vision. So the whole looking up, down, and side to side thing really doesn't do anything. If I was being generous, maybe it'll help for some people with bad eye strain, or maybe for people who have poor eye coordination after something like a head injury. But again, that'd be being pretty generous. The focusing up close on your nose bit is really the only part of this that has some mild truth to it. See, your eyeballs have three distinct muscles within them, two of which are part of the iris, the colored part of your eye. Yeah. Those are, in fact, two different muscles working together to make your pupils either really large or really small. And when you're focusing on a near object, your pupils constrict, get smaller, creating what's called a pinhole effect, which will increase your ability to focus on a near object, basically improving what's called your depth of field or making your range of clear vision a little bit wider. You can even test this principle out on your own by creating a little pinhole size with your fingers like this over an eye, and you should see things in the distance and up close seem just a little bit sharper. The other muscle within the eye, which is the true powerhouse for being able to focus up close, is called the ciliary body. And when you flex this muscle, it relaxes tension on the lens inside the eye, which is kind of like a glasses lens, except it's flexible and allows you to focus on near objects. So when Paul McCartney has been doing these eye exercises, his eye yoga, to focus on his nose, he's essentially been teaching his muscle to flex more inside of the eye to relax the lens and allow it to focus better up close. And this is not medical news, as doing pencil push-up eye exercises has been long used to help for kids that have a condition called accommodative insufficiency, where they're not able to fully coordinate using those specific muscles, as well as for people who've had traumatic brain injury or any sort of head injury, because in most of those cases, they also lose coordination using these muscles. This is commonly used in an evidence-based eye care practice called vision therapy, where you are prescribed eye exercises that show that it improves things for lazy eye, double vision, and other neurological conditions. But still, even with that part of focusing on your nose being somewhat true, there's still many factors at play when it comes to you doing eye exercises, not being data-driven, and the reason why most eye doctors will laugh or maybe do an eye roll whenever somebody mentions doing it. For somebody like Paul McCartney, who's in his late 70s and is claiming not to need glasses, he is well into what we call presbyopia, which sets in after about the age of 50 and is where the lens inside of your eye grows so thick it begins to start to harden. And with that lens hardening, even if you're using that muscle inside your eye to focus, the lens still cannot change shape and you can no longer use it to focus on your objects. That is why everybody after about the age of 50 usually ends up needing bifocals or reading glasses. It's just a normal part of aging. That means for someone like Paul, who's 78, even though he is flexing his muscles to focus on his nose, that lens inside his eye is not able to flex, and so it's not really what's giving him good vision. Now, I personally do not know Paul McCartney's eye health, and even if I did, I wouldn't share it because that would be breaking HIPAA laws. But if it's true that he does not need reading glasses or even prescription glasses, here are probably the reasons why. Number one is that as we age, our pupils get smaller and smaller, and when we're reading up close, they get smaller still. So when Paul is focusing on a near object, his pupils get so small, the pinhole effect essentially gets better, and he has a wider range of clear vision. And it's really helpful for looking at things like your phone or reading a book. Again, it gives you just more leeway to kind of trombone your way in finding that sweet spot. The second reason is that at least one or both of his eyes are probably mildly nearsighted. That means that he can see up close a little bit easier, and he's just gotten used to seeing things in the distance being a little bit blurry, but enough for him to get by. Again, I don't know what his visual acuity is, but I'll tell you, Paul, if you ever watch this and you want to come out to our clinic so we can do a thorough test, you're always welcome to come on over. Or perhaps, like most people over their 70s, they've had something like cataract surgery, where they remove that hardened lens inside the eye and they replace it with a new implant. And thankfully, these days, we have really advanced technologies which allow for our implants to be either multifocal or trifocal to give you that extra clear distance vision as well as up close. Now again, I don't know if Paul's already had cataract surgery or not. I know he's a longtime like vegetarian advocate, and studies do show that people who eat more vegetables, such as vegetarians or vegans, have a less risk for things like cataracts. As far as the argument that eye yoga or doing eye exercises to improve vision or to reverse the need for prescription glasses, unfortunately, there is just little to no evidence that suggests that this is even possible. Almost all anecdotal reports from people claiming that eye exercises have helped them can usually be explained by some other mechanism at play. But I'll tell you that if there was ever good evidence that suggests that doing eye yoga or eye exercises could prevent or reverse the need for glasses, eye doctors would instantly jump on board, be recommending it, and prescribing it for people. But unfortunately, right now, there's just no evidence for it. But again, don't confuse the eye yoga and these type of eye exercises that we're talking about here with what is called vision therapy, which is a well-documented and study subspecialty of eye care, which really does help people for certain eye conditions. So if you are somebody who's a kid with lazy eye or double vision, or if you've had brain injury in any way and you're having trouble focusing, then definitely try to find somebody in your area that offers something like vision therapy. But hey, if you found value in this video, click that like button for me and let me know in the comments what your thoughts are on all of this on eye yoga. Have you tried it yourself? Any positive or negative kind of issues with it? Just what are your thoughts? Drop in the comment section below. And stay tuned and make sure you subscribe to the channel because I hope to have one of my vision therapist friends come on the channel so we can break down these myths and issues with eye focusing and all of that a little bit more. And please understand that I know a lot of people want something like eye exercises to work. I personally try to stay really open-minded about this, but I myself have to follow evidence-based practices. And also please understand the little we've gone over in this video is barely scratching the surface for how complex the eye coordination and eye teaming really is. And as always, if you're having problems with your eyes and vision, make sure to call your local eye doctor and see them right away. Otherwise, keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.